The whole societal scenario where the production possibilities curve or production possibilities frontier is fixed and the choice will be some point on that fixed curve stems from the original assumption that the resources are fixed. Just as a quick recap, what are the categories of resources? Remember, land is any natural resource, labor is any human service, capital, which is not money, is machinery and equipment, and the last category is entrepreneurial ability, where the entrepreneur is someone who, one, recognizes a profit opportunity, two, is willing to accept risk, and three, is able to organize the other resources. But what if the resources aren't fixed? If resources change, what happens to production possibilities? The answer, of course, is it depends. If there are suddenly more resources, then there is a greater capability to produce, and the PPC moves outward or shifts to the right. Now, just to illustrate a side point, let me call the two broad categories of output agriculture, like wheat, and manufacturing, like computers. These categories are often used in production possibilities models because they use resources differently. Agriculture tends to be more labor intensive, whereas manufacturing tends to be more capital or machinery intensive. Why does this matter? Well, I just wanted to point out that underlying resources changes won't necessarily result in a nice, even, parallel shift of the production possibilities. Consider this. Suppose we're producing efficiently using all of our resources operating on PPC1. Then suddenly, someone discovers a fabulous new fertilizer that doubles crop yields. What happens to the possible agricultural output when you use all of the existing resources plus you add this fabulous new fertilizer? You can now produce much more wheat than you could before. But what happens to the manufacturing output when you use all of the existing resources and then add fertilizer? Probably nothing. So the new PPC, PPC 2, does illustrate an expanded ability to produce, but it's an uneven shift. For now, though, just to keep things simpler, I'm just going to show even parallel shifts. So where were we? Okay. An increase in resources will result in an outward shift of PPC, demonstrating a greater ability to produce. Okay, then what happens if resources decrease? Fewer resources mean less ability to produce, so the production possibilities will shrink or shift inward. Now, I want you to think about something. What does it actually mean to say that there's an increase or a decrease in resources? How does it happen? More specifically, how would a society see more land, more labor, more capital, or more entrepreneurial ability? In this table, I've gotten you started. Now you complete the rest. Next time, markets.